So we had a 2 week period after the season had finished until the Champions League final. And we were in pretty much every day training, ready, getting ready for that final. And I played in the last game of the season against Aston Villa at home at Anfield. Played well in the game, and it was just, I need to train well now for 2 weeks and prove that I can get into this squad. Because I've pretty much been in every squad throughout the season. I don't think there was many that I wasn't involved in. And then we were due to fly to Istanbul 2 days before the game. So every time that you walked into the changing room after training, the squad list would be up. And you could see all the lads running over to it because the list would go up of 18 players. So you knew it was the 11 players and then the subs. There was no other players involved. And the squad list went up and I was in the squad. So I just literally showered, changed out as quick as I could and straight on the phone to family. Get your flights booked, get your hotels booked. We're going to Istanbul, I'm in the squad. And it was just amazing feeling to think that you're going to the biggest game in the club's history in however many years and being part of that. And then about three hours later, I got a phone call from the assistant manager just saying we've made a mistake on the squad, on the squad list, and I wasn't in the squad. And that was tough to take because it wasn't the manager who'd rang me, it was the assistant manager. And
is it Paco?
Paco Ayestarán. So I lost all respect for Rafa there and then, because for him not to pick up the phone and in the biggest game of the season in recent years as well, to do that, I lost all respect for him.
What do you tell your family?
They couldn't believe it. They were sort of saying, there's lots of things that happen in football, and there's just an old saying, that's football for you. And that's all anyone ever says, that's football for you. It doesn't happen in any other work industry, or it wouldn't happen because there'd be sanctions for it, there'd be things that could happen, you can sue them, you can do this, that, and you can't in football. You've just got to get on with it and there's nothing you can do. I wasn't happy about the situation, but what can I do? I can't suddenly turn around to the manager and say, well, you put me in originally, now put me back in. It just doesn't happen. And then the most probably frustrating part for me after that was the next day we were due to fly home and have a parade around Liverpool, and I thought, well, at least I can go and be involved in that. And they flew the wives of the full 18 squad on the plane home, and we didn't make that plane. They put us on a different plane and missed the tour.
You missed the tour?
Yeah, I got home halfway through the tour and I watched it at home on Sky Sports News.
Did Rafa at any point address not just the 18, was it 18-man squad for the final? Did he ever address the whole squad to say that you all won it as opposed to just the 18?
No, I don't think he did. I think when we came back in the after that night, came back in the summer, he pulled myself and a few other players and apologised for what had happened. And we were all of the mindset, well, that apology's come too late. You've had all summer to apologise. You should have picked the phone up earlier. And that was it, really. There was nothing else to say because he'd let it go for too long.
Do you think credit was given not just by Rafa, but by Liverpool Football Club, to the entire squad? Because like you said, you play in, what, 7 games from qualifiers right up to the quarterfinals.
Yeah, and the thing is that we don't get put as Champions League winners, even though we've played our part in the competition, whereas Roy Keane gets suspended for a game in the final and he's a Champions League winner. John Terry misses the final, he's a Champions League winner. Now, we miss the final, but not through suspension or injury, but through just not being involved and not being picked, and we don't get classed as Champions League winners. And it's very strange to think that, but that's the way it is. But no, I think the club didn't handle it well. I think the writing was on the wall for me, and I wanted to leave at that point.